Well, the next track final, the men's 1500 metres. British interest here from Robert Harrison and Tony Morell. Surprisingly, for an event in which we've done so well outdoors, it's 11 years since Britain won a medal. But at the moment, we have a world record to our credit, owned by a British athlete, following Peter Elliott's magnificent performance in Seville on Tuesday night. Elliott really brimming with confidence after 12 successive wins, perfectly paced. The record held by Irishman Marcus O'Sullivan, 3:35.6. Although some statisticians said he ran even quicker during a mile race, Elliott removed all possible doubts with his time, 3:34.21. And on this very track, a week ago, Peter Elliott destroyed Jens-Peter Herold of East Germany, who now lines up in the final for the 1500 metres as the favourite to win the gold medal. Sadly, no Peter Elliott. Of course, he decided to end his season after that performance in Seville, and why not? You couldn't end on a much higher note than that, could you? There's the lineup then. Stefan Brandt of West Germany, Fermin Cacho of Spain, Jens-Peter Herold, East Germany, Tony Morell, Great Britain, Teofilo Benito of Spain, Rob Harrison for Great Britain, Antonio Monteiro of Portugal, and Robert Banai from Hungary. Eight men, two Spaniards, two British athletes, and here's one of them, Tony Morell. Fifth in the Commonwealth Games, third against the GDR here, over 800 metres in the recent match, well beaten by Tom McKean on that occasion. Excellent indoor record, fourth all-time over 800 metres with 1:45.72. Beaten some of the best indoors and out throughout his career. A hard man, used to be a welder up in Hartlepool. 1:29, Stefan Brandt, the West German national champion. There's Herold, 2:23, next to Morell. 53 is Benito, real star as a junior, and then the old man, 30-year-old Robert Harrison. Harrison, a former European indoor champion himself. Over 800 metres, he won the gold medal 5 years ago. 7.5 laps of the track, a cagey sort of opening here, with no one really wanting to commit themselves. Herold is almost forced to the front, flanked on either side by the West German Brandt and the Portuguese runner, Monteiro, who only qualified for this final as the fastest loser. Morell, two from the rear of the field at present, and Herold very reluctantly goes to the front, and it could hardly be said he's speeded it up. And rather like the women's 1500 metres, this is going to be a tactical race with a sprint finish, I would think, Steve Ovett.
Yes, it looks like that way at the moment, but I hope that someone like Tony Morell doesn't leave it to a last lap sprint finish. I would have thought that his best advantage would be to take it up with maybe three laps to go and try and stretch the real sprint men out and tire them somewhat before the last lap, because really I don't think he's got that sort of stronger kick over the last 200 metres. But Herold, really, I suppose, the class man in the field, although I feel perhaps at the moment he's running slightly tired. He's run, I think, 19 races this year alone indoors, and that must have some effect on your training and your racing anyway. So he may be a little bit tired, and getting out front there at the moment, maybe just boosting his confidence that he's controlling the race and letting things be dictated by his own tactics. But the guys behind are just looking around, taking stock of the situation, and one would hope that some of our guys, even if it's only with three laps or four laps to go, will make an improvement on this sort of pace.
4.5 laps to go. Herold of East Germany in the lead. A lot of movement behind him, and suddenly the Spaniard, one of the Spaniards, quickens things up at the front. It's Benito. So Benito of Spain in the lead, and his teammate Cacho races up to join him as well. So it's Benito, Spain, Herold, East Germany, Cacho of Spain, Brandt of West Germany on the inside, just moving into third place now. Rob Harrison is fifth, and Tony Morell still at the back, although moving through on the inside when he saw a gap. It really all happened in that lap, Steve.
Yes, I thought the nerve would suddenly snap on someone, and Benito decided that the pace was ridiculously slow and got out there, but he hasn't really pushed it that hard. Herold is there, he usually goes with two laps to go, but as I say, that Tony is now coming through with three laps to go. That's a great sort of performance, because he's got to really go out there and work hard. Let's hope that, having made the decision, he really does push it.
He won't be lacking support, that's for sure. Herold has gone with him. Cacho of Spain moves into third. Brandt of West Germany is fourth. Then Benito of Spain, fifth. Two laps to go. Tony Morell of Great Britain leads the field in this 1500 metres, but Cacho, the Spaniard, has gone in front of him. He's holding off Herold on the bend. Now Herold. moves into second. Brandt of West Germany closing on Morel, who's still holding on to the bronze medal position. Just over a lap to go. Fermín Cacho of Spain, the world junior bronze medalist a couple of years ago, takes them into the final 200 metres. Herold of East Germany second, Morel of Great Britain third, Brandt of West Germany fourth. Morel's digging in hard, and the crowd are giving him fantastic support here. He's in the bronze medal position, and that, I think, is the medal he'll settle for. Herold wins it. Cacho second. Morel, a bronze medal. But the East German, Jens-Peter Herold, the pre-race favourite, the bronze medalist from the Olympic Games in Seoul, is the new European indoor champion. A fine run, though, by Tony Morel. You can never fault an athlete when he goes bravely with three laps to go, as Morel did, and he certainly got a medal in a hard way.
That's right, he gave it his best shot, and I think that's as much as you can do. These two guys, Cacho and Herold, looked good in the semi-finals, I must admit. Cacho played the same trick he did in the semi-finals by going with 400 metres to go, pushing hard, digging in. He's a real little grafter, that boy. He really does work hard. But Herold, really at the moment, I suppose, is race fit. He's raced 19 times this year, using his strength to get past Cacho and take the final. But he looked a little bit tired. Cacho got, I think, deservedly a silver medal, and Tony the bronze. Great run.
Well, Tony Morel, as I was saying during the race, been around a long time and produced some very good performances and beaten some very good people. But there's nothing like a medal to boost an athlete's confidence, and a bronze medal here will be something he will wear with great pride.